a lot of communities across the country are facing issues around worsening air quality, the prospect of flooding, and in some cases, the heat that is generated inside of city centers.
I think the approach that Climate Cabinet is taking is effectively bringing data and making it more actionable and to make sure that the resources that are being directed into these communities are connected to the ability to advocate for the appropriate policy at the state or federal level. We're only as good as what we know, and so if we don't actually make sure that we're equipping policymakers and their teams with the issues that their residents face, I think we'll lose the argument on climate change.
Hey y'all, my name's Caroline Spears, and I'm so excited to be with you here today. I run Climate Cabinet, where we make local climate action easy. This summer, we've seen storm after storm hit cities across America. Cities like Houston, Texas. That's where I grew up. And as a kid, we evacuated from hurricanes. These events used to be rare, but now we have weekly megastorms and fire seasons. Y'all, we know climate change is bad and we have to turn this thing around. So at Climate Cabinet, we're using a new approach to win. We're like Moneyball for climate. Moneyball is a baseball term. It's a way to use data to identify undervalued players that have game-winning potential. We're applying this methodology to climate policymakers. In the US, most money and effort to reverse climate change is deployed at the federal level. But in America, there are 500,000 policymakers. That's right, I said 500,000. Think city councils and utility boards. According to research by Bloomberg Philanthropies, these local offices have big impact. They're responsible for half of our climate progress to date, but they get a fraction of the resources. Take, for example, a local school board. You might not think that school boards could help impact climate change, but they can if they know how. This school board in Alexandria, Virginia, switched their entire school bus fleet to electric vehicles. Now, pollution doesn't spew into bus stops, protecting kids' health and solving the climate crisis at the same time. There are thousands of communities just like Alexandria who are still using expensive polluting technology, but they don't have to be. These school board members are all potential climate change makers, and they have power that the federal government doesn't. At Climate Cabinet, we're harnessing that power. We're building the most comprehensive data set on local climate potential in the country. And this is where our Moneyball approach comes in. We're using data and stats to identify who, out of those 500,000 elected officials, have a high ROI for climate impact, but maybe they just don't know it yet. It works in other use cases too. For example, our data platform surfaced that next year, approximately 2,000 utility board members will vote on fossil fuel contracts. We'll equip these 2,000 utility board members with a policy toolkit that outlines everything they need to turn their community green. What's more, we'll inform local climate activists of key dates, decisions, and legislature contact information so that they can push for change. We created this tool because we needed it. When my co-founder Emma was working as an organizer, she had limited resources and wanted to have an outsized impact. The same thing happened for me when I was volunteering for a state legislature. She wanted to make climate-informed decisions, but didn't know how. Today, we're raising $1.5 million to build our data platform. We'll identify and rank a roster of highest impact policymakers who together will help reverse climate change. Join us and our team of underdog local policymakers in a fight for a just and livable future before it's too late. Thank you.